In this tutorial, we're going to look at the shift list component. So we're going to look at how you use some of these list management components to actually affect geometry in Rhino and Grasshopper. So let's go ahead and just start by making two circles. I'll just actually copy this one, move it vertically, and then we'll just bring both of these in as curves into Grasshopper. So I'll set one curve, I'll set the top one, and then I'll set the second one. Okay, and then we can hide those. And then let's go ahead and divide. Use our divide component. Divide both of these curves. And we'll just use the same number of divisions for each of these. So I'll just use a slider from 2 less than 20. Let's go a little bigger. 2 less than 50. And I'll just plug these both into number. Oops. Okay. And then you can just toggle that to see it divide those curves. So now what we want to do is create a line between the points. So we're going to use our line component, and that'll create just a straight line from index 0 to index 0, index 1 to index 1, etc. So it just kind of goes around the circle and connects each index to its corresponding index in the list. So remember, if we pull a panel out of here, you can see that all the zeros will create a line to the other zeros. So sometimes you don't want them to go directly from one to the next. You actually want to shift them and create a little more dynamic geometry. So we can use what's called the shift list component. And so we could take one of these lists. Let's take this bottom list here. And you can actually shift it by a certain number of indices. So we can create a new slider. Let's go 0 less than 20. Plug that into our shift. And then we can now plug our shifted components or shifted points into that line. So right now I'm not shifting them at all. I'm shifting them 0. But as soon as I start to move this, you'll see they'll shift 1, then 2, then 3, etc. So you can actually start shifting these things, and then it will change basically the index number of the shifted list, so that it's always still going to connect 0 to 0, but the indexes, the geometry themselves, have shifted so that 0 is no longer 0. It's a new 0 based on how many times you're shifting it. The other thing you have is this wrap. And so what happens with these lists is it'll go from 0, and it'll try to assign 0 to 0, 1 to 1, 2 to 2, etc. And then when it gets to the bottom, if it doesn't have anything to match, it'll then go to the beginning of the list again. So you can see if we wrap this, if we turn it on to false, it'll stop at the last one and then use the last one to connect to all the remaining items in the other list. So if you have true, it'll just keep going around and wrapping those numbers until they match. So that's what the W stands for, that's wrap. So as you can see, all these list management components allow you to do quite a bit of manipulation with the data itself, and that creates a really interesting effect in the geometry.